Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and now we'll see what are JavaScript variables. So we'll see each and everything about JavaScript variables. So now let's say that you are printing something like this. So you have console.log 2 plus 3, right? So when you execute this in console, this will give you output 5, right? Now let's say again if you want to change something, so let's say now you want to apply 6, you save it and then you again reload it. So now you are getting output as 8, right? But you don't want to change it like this. So basically you want to have variable, right? So variable means that rather than showing as a static value, we can have a variable. So rather than 2 plus 6, we can say, let's see, a plus b, right? So basically a plus b, so a and b are the variables, right? So now I want to assign a value. So variable means basically what we do, we basically assign the value in the variables. So let's say if I have here var a and var b, right? So this is how I have assigned. Now I can say, okay, a is 2 and let's say b is 6, right? And then rather than this 2 plus 6, I can say a plus b, right? And if you save it and if you reload it, so you could see that you have still 8. Now let's say again if you change it to 5, so now it should be a plus b, which should be 7, right? So if you see, now it has changed to 7, right? So this is how we declare any variable. So what we do, we declare a variable, then we assign the value, and then we use it in as arithmetic operation or anywhere in the JavaScript code, right? Now again, like using var, basically it was before the ES6, but after ES6 you can also use the let. So if you use the let again, if you save it and if you run the program, it would work, right? So basically after ES6 you can use let. So when we'll use the object, so we'll see that what's the difference between var and let, right? So now we have seen that what are the variables, it means assigning a value, then var and let, it means we can use let post ES6. Now there are some basic rules when we are declaring any variable. So first of all, that we cannot have a variable cannot have space or hyphen. It means that let's say this is my variable, so I cannot have, let's say if I'm declaring a variable, this is fine, so let's say if I'm declaring variable a space c, right? So this is not a valid case. That's why you can see this is giving me error, because I have put a space in between, so this is not valid. In fact if you, so let me put it in another line, and this is my first, sorry, yep. Now again, let's say you can't have a hyphen here, right? So this is again not valid. So you could see that this is not valid case, right? Now you cannot start any variable by any number. So you cannot say like 3 and a, right? Again, this is not a valid case, because this is not expected one. Other than this one, you can use any variable. So like you can have after any character, you can use this, right? In fact, you can use underscore, this is also fine. Then you can have any capital, smaller, so that is again fine, right? So this is the basic rule. Now so that we have seen what is variable, what is difference between var and let, we cannot have a space and we cannot start with number. Now we'll see that what are the constant variable. So constant variable means, let's say what you have seen here, that let's say if I define a equals to 2 and b equals to 4, right? So what I'm doing, so basically at the declaration time, I'm defining the value, right? And if you run this, so if you run this, if you save this, so it will printing you 6, right? Because that was your starting value. Now let's say later if you change a and b to something, so now let's say if I change a to 3 and b to 10, right? And if you run the program, so what you can see, now it is changed to 13, right? So earlier value was 2 and 4, but now it has changed to 3 and 10. So, but let's see if I don't want to change the starting value, if I don't want to change the initial value. So rather than let, I will define it using const, right? So I will say these are constant, right? And if I save it and if I run this, so what you can see here that assignment to constant variable is type error, right? So that's the case that when you have the constant, then you can't change. So in many cases we don't want to change a variable. So in that case we can define a constant variable, right? Now we'll see that what are the type of JavaScript variable that we have, right? So basically we have the primitive type and we have the reference type. So these are the two types of JavaScript variable that we have. And in primitive we can have the string, we can have number, boolean, undefined and null, right? So one by one we'll see that what's the point of this one. So let me again, or let me show you on the console. Let's say my age 2. So now what is the type of a? Type of a is number. So if I, so we have basically type of, and if I use type of a, you will see the output is number, right? It means this, we have the one of the type which is number and the type of a is number. Now let's say if I define that a equals to, let's say true, right? So this is another type. So now if I say that type of, so if I say type of a, so this is boolean now, right? So this is again boolean. Now let's say if I define type a equals to, let's say here test. So now what is type of a? This is a string, right? So one, we have number, this is one primitive type, then another primitive type if boolean, another primitive type is string, right? And another primitive type is null. So I can have that, let's say a equals to null, right? And what is the type of null? So type of null is always an object, right? So we'll see later that what are the objects. So objects are basically reference type, so that we'll see later, right? Now we have another type is, which is undefined. So let's say if I declare it as undefined, and if I want to check what is type of a, so type of a is undefined, right? So whenever we define a value as undefined, the type of that value is always undefined, right? So that's what we have seen, that we have checked string, number, boolean, undefined and null, right? So these all are, whatever we have covered, these are primitive type. Then we have the reference type. So array, function and object, they all are of reference type JavaScript variable. So we'll see array, function, object one by one because they are big topic, so we'll see it separately. But in this thing we have covered primitive type, right? Now dynamic typing. So dynamic typing means, so as you have seen that at the starting my a was number, right? Then I declared my a was a2 boolean, then I declared my a2 null, then I declared my a2 undefined, right? So what I'm doing, I'm basically changing the type of a single variable a, right? So this is the dynamic typing, means you can change the type of a variable based on the value you are assigning to. So like earlier when I assigned a number, my type was number, but when I assigned that the boolean value true, then my type changed to boolean. Then when I assigned to a string, then my type changed to a string, right? So this is how we call JavaScript variable as dynamic typing variable. But like in Java, so once you have defined int a equal to 2, now you can't say a equals to a string or a equal to true, right? Or a equal to false, because there you have the static type. You declare one, when you declare that int a equal to 2, then that's it. But here basically we define using let a equal to 2 or var equal to 2. So here we don't define the what is a type, right? So when we define in Java int a equal to 2, there you are defining that this a equals to integer. But here When we define let a equal to 2, it means a can be of any typing based on that value which you are assigning, right? So this is a dynamic typing. So guys, about JavaScript variable, I think that's sufficient, and we'll cover the reference type later when we'll cover individual topic, array function and object, right? And if you have any doubt regarding this JavaScript variable, so please write in the comment section and I will try to explain that. So thanks guys, and if you have liked the video, then please like it and please subscribe to the channel to watch more videos. Thank you.